Florida State Bank of Davis Annals on August 25th, 1947, as the first Black-owned and operated bank of the Midwest. Named in his honor of civil rights leader Frederick Douglass, the bank captured his vision of providing financial opportunities and economic freedom for Black people. And whereas H.W. Sewing served as chairman of Douglas State Bank and president of the H.W. Sewing and Company, Inc. insurance firm, and helped establish other business ventures, including Sentinel Loan Investment Company and Black-owned banks in Houston and St. Louis. And whereas Mr. Sewing married his college sweetheart, Rebecca Whitman, September 20th, 1972, and was devoted to her for 52 years until her death on June 23rd, 1969. We had two daughters, Margaret Walker and Dimple Jameson. And whereas H.W. Sewing consistently endeavored to nurture and mentor the younger generation of entrepreneurs and businessmen, including Donald Sewing of Kansas and Richard Sewing of Houston, Texas. And whereas H.W. Sewing, who died November 1st, 1980, led a remarkable life governed by his unwavering faith and desire to uplift, educate, and help advance Black people. Now, therefore, I, Tyrone Garner, Mayor, CEO of the Unified Government of Wyandotte County, Kansas City, Kansas, do hereby proclaim March 16, 2024, as Henry Ward Sewing Day.
Yeah. All right.
Kansas City, Kansas, a witness whereof I have hereunto set my hand at the seal of the Unified Government of Wyandotte County, Kansas City.
Yay!
Woohoo!
I pointed to him. I don't know. And Mayor Garner, CEO, is here up front and allowing me to read his proclamation. Thank you. From Kansas City, Missouri, recognizing March 16, 2024 as Henry W. Sewing Day. Whereas Henry W. Sewing established the Douglas State Bank in the city of Kansas City, Kansas in 1947 and served the banking needs of the population of African descent in both Kansas City, Kansas and Kansas City, Missouri. And whereas Douglas State Bank was the first Black-owned and operated bank in the Midwest. And whereas Mr. Henry W. Sewing received numerous awards for service to his community over his lifetime, establishing financial avenue that contributed to making the greater Kansas City area a better, safer place financially, socially. And whereas Mr. Sewing said the cornerstones for the development of Black communities contribute to the growth of Black families and created economic empowerment in Missouri and Kansas. And whereas Henry W. Sewing always exhibited a remarkable work ethic, commitment to professionalism, and dedication to the people of the greater Kansas City area, Mr. Sewing established a legacy of community building, economic enhancement, and commitment. And whereas the legacy of Henry W. Sewing lives on in the annals of history, and with the installation of the mural by famed Kansas City artist Hank Smith, which is housed at the Black Archives of Mid-America in Kansas City. And now, therefore, as mayor of the city of Kansas City, I, Quentin D. Lucas, on behalf of the citizens of this great city, do hereby proclaim March 16, 2024, as Henry W. Sewing Day in Kansas City. Around the world could come and see and share this. Come back, come off and bring people.
Thanks, Joshua.
Is so very important to him, and he wouldn't have it. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure. I'm personally elevated. I want to thank the Soul family and thank those that are here, certainly to my friend, Dr. Williams. I wish I had put together a certificate as the mayor has, Mayor Garner has, because she just read it so well. She would have. It would have uplifted what words I have to say from my heart right now. This is indeed such a joyous occasion. We know historically what it meant and what it means to have had a bank, a black bank, what it does for a community, and what the Soul family, HWSM, bank where I played as a child on the floor there in Washington. My father, George Hayden, great George Hayden, moved to the state center, had his office there. I know there were other offices in the bank that were fostered. We talked a lot about banking within our community today. But what the Douglas Bank meant was not just an economic institution for us to trade and the foundation that was laid by the hard work of H.W. Soane, but also fostered law offices then, the father of Stephen Jackson, Haley Davis. It was a hub, a center, a place where we could gather and foster entrepreneurship and inspire our community. So I know my minute is up, but I just want to say what a fellowship this is to remember to have that real so many days of my life. The downside that I have after living here is I just wish I knew I had a different name. Of course, we know Soane, but there are other names too that are not known so well to me, but I hope they will be others because we need to continue within our community to inspire each other, to use these examples, these precepts of genuine commitment to who and how we are as an independent and proud community to foster from within ourselves those abilities. This is a proud moment, this is a proud day. As that mural hangs there for many generations to see, I hope that we will continue to enshrine to our hearts and minds the commitment to ourselves and our community. It's like Soane, and so many did, not only through the Douglas Bank, but through so many other opportunities that we have. I thank you again for the honor of letting me share on behalf of the state family, KCK, but also too on behalf of the grateful, beloved community that which H.W. Soane and the Douglas Bank meant and that the mural here.
Yes. Forever, forever. That mural is forever now in the museum.
And columnist, very new columnist, Mr. Tim Columnist for the Houston Chronicle. And guys, as a newspaper person, I want to tell you that's something to be very proud of. They don't give a lot of black people opportunities to be a columnist at a major newspaper, I said. So that says a lot about her ability and respect that they have for her as an individual. So just proud as heck of her, and this is who should be for her connections to Kansas City, and she's going to come and speak about her the uncle, Soane. The uncle, Soane.
I love y'all. Thank you so much. I'll talk to y'all later.
I'm from Houston. A girlfriend who had
young children, and we had a play date. And she happened to share with me that her father owned Black Banks. And she was from New Orleans. And her name is Heidi, her maiden name McDonald. And